everyone, it's Shelby from Learn Thai with Shelby. Welcome to my channel and welcome to this video. Sexual orientation technically describes the enduring pattern of attraction of which sex or gender are you attracted to, and that enduring pattern of attraction will determine your sexual orientation. If you are heterosexual, or basically you just want to say I'm straight. If you are a man, you would say ผมเป็นผู้ชาย or ผมชอบผู้หญิง which means I like girls. If you are a woman, you would say ฉันเป็นผู้หญิง or ฉันชอบผู้ชาย which means I like guys. We use different words for men and women who are attracted to the same gender. If you were born as a man but you like men, then you are gay. So we just call it gay, just like in English. The question is being gay acceptable in Thailand? The answer is yes, but for some people they can't act openly because of their career or because of their family not accepting it. Gang. I talk about this in animal slang words. If you haven't watched it, you can check it out by clicking on the right corner. You can also say Guang. Gang and Guang are used to describe a man that dresses and acts like a man but likes men. Tut. It's also a common way to call someone gay, but sometimes people call ladyboys tut as well, and there isn't a right or wrong for that, but some people might get offended if they are called tut. It's a man who dresses like a man but acts camp. When it comes to being gay in Thai, we also have words for givers and takers, which are gay rap and gay ruk. Gay rap means a guy who like to be on bottom, and gay ruk means a guy who likes to be on top. So if you are gay, people might have asked you, are you a giver or a taker? เป็นรับหรือเป็นรุกเป็นรับหรือเป็นรุก and they will drop the word gay because it's obvious that you are gay. ไม้ป่าเดียวกัน is also a common way to call someone gay if you don't wanna offend anybody, but it can't be used for lesbians. กะเทย. Most people misspelled these words as กระเทย. The correct spelling is without รอเรือ. A trick to remembering it is กะเทยเป็นได้เลยไม่ต้องรอ. Meaning, if you want to be a ladyboy, you don't have to wait. Just do it. So, รอเรือ is รอ, which means to wait in Thai. I have been asked the question, is the word กะเทย offensive? It really depends on the person. Some people don't care, but some do. To be safe, don't call anyone กะเทย the first time that you meet them, and don't ask a girl if she is a ladyboy or not. เป็นกระเทยหรือเปล่า? คุณเป็นกระเทยไหม? Don't say that. Another way to call a ladyboy is สาวสอง, which is shortened form of สาวประเภทสอง. สาวประเภทสอง or สาวสอง are acceptable for both written and spoken language, and it sounds more respectful for them. Tomboy is a borrower that we used to call a girl that dresses like a boy but like girls, but we say only tom. So this term in Thai is used differently to English. I've been asked this question a lot. เป็นทอมหรือเปล่า? Are you a tomboy? There's a type of girl that likes tomboys, and we call them D. They just dress and behave like normal girl, but they don't like guys. The term of lesbians is also a borrowed that we use in Thai too, but we say it only les, but not an S actually. Let. เป็นเลสหรือเปล่า? ป็นเลสหรือเปล่า Are you a lesbian? Teaching is common slang that is used for being a lesbian. Teaching literally means scratching symbols the Thai instrument. This one. In slang, it means girl on girl. It comes from two symbols that are striking one another, which is in comparison to the same gender. เธอชอบตีชิงไหม? เธอชอบตีชิงไหม? Are you a lesbian? คนส่วนมากคิดว่าฉันชอบตีชิง. คนส่วนมากคิดว่าฉันชอบตีชิง. Alright, that's it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and find it educational. And please give me a big thumbs up. If you have any questions or anything that you want me to cover, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you in the next one. Have a nice day, and I hope you guys get laid.